Hey everybody, one day I've met a problem. I need to make a text that appears from a smoke. I tried to search for some tutorial on YouTube, but unfortunately many people have just filled YouTube's search index with their 15 seconds videos that contain sometimes nice and sometimes crappy results. But there are almost no tutorials on how to do that. So I decided, okay, I will do it by myself without any third party plugins, and if I succeed, I will certainly make a tutorial. And you know I succeeded, so here is my tutorial on how to make smoke to text or vice versa text to smoke effect in Adobe After Effects using only out-of-the-box functionality. First, we need a composition with some text that we want to appear from smoke. Name of the comp is text. Now let's create a baseline composition smoke, where we will do greater part of the work, and put our text here. The basis for our smoke is Effect Layer Explorer, that is part of Particle Playground. In order to apply this effect, we need to create a new solid and enable Particle Playground for this solid. By default, Canon and Gravity are enabled, so let's turn them off. And now in Layer Explorer, select our text as layer that will generate particles. The important thing here is that particles will be generated on every frame, so if you don't disable generation after a few frames, you'll get a tons of particles and your PC will not be able to draw these. We use 3 frames to generate particles, and at 4th frames set the radius of new particles to 0, that means disabling generation. As you can see, we have only 3 frames that generate particles, and the total number of particles is more than 100,000. Now let's smoothly hide text layer, so after 2nd frame only particles will be visible. Here are our particles, but we need not particles, but smoke. First blur will help us to make particles look smoothly. Okay, so our particles are now smooth, but... That don't impress me much. Oh yeah! So I want to bring some life to these particles, and there are property mappers for this purpose. In order to use property mapper, we need a layer that contains a map for properties. Create new composition called properties map. Create new solid and apply fractal noise effect to it. Now you'll see how I animate this map, but this is not the only way. You can try to play with settings if you want, you can use something other than fractal noise, or you even can make this map colored. Later you'll see that this can have sense. Thank you. Our properties map is ready, added to smoke composition and height. As you can see, there are persistent and ephemeral property mappers. If you want to clearly understand what is this and what is the difference, you should read the After Effects help and make some experiments with property mapper by yourself. I'll leave detailed explanation of this feature out of scope of this tutorial. In persistent property mapper, select properties map in Use layers map. It's possible to map different color channels to different properties, but our properties map is black and white, so it doesn't matter red, green or blue channel we use to map to property. Let's map to mass, so that mass of any particle that passes over the darkest pixels in the properties map will have 0.05 of some arbitrary units of mass, and mass of any particle that passes the brightest pixels will have 1 arbitrary unit of mass. Now, if you apply some horizontal force, then our particles will obtain different accelerations and therefore different velocities. So map next color channel to x-force. Negative values mean that force pushes particles counter to the direction of the x-axis, that is from right to left. We can also stretch particles along x-axis by mapping third color channel to x-scale. I believe this explanation is a good start from scratch for you to understand how property mappers work. Now go to ephemeral property mapper and map channels to opacity and y-speed. Let's return to our first blur and animate it to make particles less blurred when they are close to text and more blurred when they are far away. Now I want to see what I made, but unfortunately I have not enough physical memory on my PC to make a preview, so I will render smoke composition. There is another reason to do this. I know that we will use one more effect to make smoke more realistic, and we need to pre-render intermediate result to be able to work comfortably with smoke. Now we should render not only RGB, but also alpha channel, otherwise our video will contain smoke with black background. And in the future, we won't be able to use created smoke with some other footage. Rendering finished, and we are importing rendered video into project. This is what we have now. The last effect that we will use to make smoke better is liquify effect. So add this effect and feel free with your distortion. I think that's enough and our smoke is ready. Thumbs up and let's render the result. If you want the smoke to fly from left to right, you can change X-force direction. And of course, we can add some footage behind the smoke. I hope you liked my tutorial. Bye till next time.